Hi, I'm Tom Coffin, CEO and president and co-founder of Simply Reliable Incorporated. Welcome to the SmartPRENEUR podcast. What's a SmartPRENEUR, you might ask? Well, a SmartPRENEUR, in our opinion, is someone that focuses on working on their business, not just in their business. And our SmartPRENEUR podcasts are designed to bring you some relevant information each week about your business and different parts of that business. It could be marketing, it could be workflow, it could be labor, it could be business operations, many things that we'll talk about each week on the podcast. You can also check out our SmartPRENEUR blog at simplyreliable.com. And of course, our SmartPRENEUR podcast is brought to you by Simply Reliable, makers of Smart Office and Design Machine, the complete end-to-end solution for business process for systems integrators. So thanks for joining us today, and I hope you enjoy the show. This week on the SmartPRENEUR podcast, our guest is Jason Sayen. Jason is the founder of I Am Sayen. Please welcome Jason Sayen. Hey, Jason, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Tom. How are you?
I'm terrific. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
Hey, SmartPRENEURs. We're going to talk with Jason Sayen today. As you may or may not know, Jason has been writing some blogs for our SmartPRENEUR blog series. And as part of that, we've created the SmartPRENEUR podcast to dig a little bit deeper. So this week's blog that we're going to discuss is one called How to Get Unstuck. And, you know, they say you're either moving forward or you're moving backwards. But if you're not moving, you know, then you're stuck in a spot or stuck in a rut or whatever. And I'm sure our SmartPRENEURs, just like us, have experienced that a time or two. And your latest blog talks about how to get unstuck. So would you share with us specifically, you know, how does someone recognize or, you know, that they're stuck? You know, how do they come to that realization where you know, we're not moving forward, not moving backwards? I'm stuck in a rut here, and I need to do something about it. I know you've got some great ideas on that.
Yeah, and that's a great question. And sometimes that's different from we have these fires that are getting created or these bottlenecks, and that's causing problems. Sometimes that's a little different than being stuck. But a couple examples I'll give you, you know, for a lot of integrators, they're trying to grow their business. And so for like a smaller integration firm, you know, they may do annual sales of 1 to 1.5 million, and that's a pretty big milestone, but they have goals to do 2 or 3 million, and they just think it's doubling their business and selling a few more projects. But literally to go from 1 to 1.5 to 2 to 3 is a huge challenge, because it's not just about selling more projects. You're going to have to bring in more employees. And I've seen a lot of integrators that had those aspirations to grow, that put in some business development plans and marketing efforts, and they just sit at that 1.5 mark for a couple of years. So they feel stuck, right? And yeah, you know, we're not going to dig into what's causing that, but that's one area you could feel stuck. Another could be on the employee side. You know, maybe you're hiring technicians and they keep leaving. And so being able to identify that area that you are stuck, it first requires the owner to, you know, have some humility, right? Ask for help. I say that a lot in a lot, yep, of these interviews, but that's the basis of any of these things, is not be too proud. And, or if you see your employees are frustrated or constantly managing some of those exceptions, those are just, you know, some kind of red lights that you're definitely stuck somewhere.
Makes sense. In the blog, you talk about something called the fishbone diagram, which I thought was fascinating. Can you share a little bit more detail about that?
Yeah, absolutely. So this is a tool that we use a lot in Lean Six Sigma, and it gets its name because when you draw out the diagram, it literally looks like a fishbone. And so it's a cause and effect diagram. And so when companies are trying to brainstorm around why something is happening and they don't fully know the root cause, they use this type of diagram. So brainstorming is very similar, but brainstorming tends to just get a lot of information out on the whiteboard, right? It's not organized in this fashion. So with the fishbone diagram, you're able to categorize and get things into a context that's easy and digestible. So for example, you know, maybe an integrator finds themselves having to always go back to a job site 45 days after the final to fix something. Now, it could be different things, right? One job, it was a network issue. Another job, it was a speaker issue. The list could go on. So on the onset, the owner sees, hey, we're rolling a truck 45 days after final every single time, but it's always something different. So the answer is not clear. And so with the fishbone diagram, you can create categories of all the potential issues that are causing the main problem, which is we roll a truck after 45 days from final. And once you have all that information, it's easier to digest what the root causes are. So, for example, you would have this diagram with these different categories with maybe the problems that you've had so far, which was a network issue, a speaker issue. And then under each of those categories, you dig a little bit deeper as to what caused that. And then that gives you that picture. And you might find out that it's poor employee training. It could be, you know, a number of things, but that fishbone diagram gives you that nice perspective in an organized format so you can quickly get on to finding a solution.
Sounds good. And SmartPRENEUR's, again, I'll bring the blog up. If you head over to our SmartPRENEUR blog series and read this specific, you know, How to Get Unstuck blog, there's a great picture of the fishbone diagram, so you can get a, you know, better image of it in case you're just listening. So you also talk, Jason, about the five W's. One of my favorites. You want to share a little bit more about those and why they might be important?
Yeah, absolutely. So that's another tool we use in Lean Six Sigma, where the fishbone diagram is more of a little bit of a structured approach. Like we finish up a project, we're going to have the team huddle, and we're going to sit down and have an hour or more conversation about what's causing all these problems. The five W's is a more casual approach. Now, you could actually use it in conjunction with the fishbone, but it's really a way to get some quick answers on why something's happening. It's less organized than the fishbone diagram. But when the causes of the problem are less obvious, the five whys helps you get to that root cause a little quicker. And it's really simple to use. You simply ask the question why five times to the group related to what the issue is. And you're going to keep getting more answers. But typically by the fifth why, you've gotten to the root cause. And so sometimes the answer to the fifth why is the cause of the problem. Sometimes all of the answers are a collection of the problems. The trick with this one is, depending how you're addressing the group or person in your company, is it can come across as you might be personally attacking them. So you just got to be cautious on how you address it. But again, if you preface it with similar approach that we talked about earlier, which is, hey, we want to make your job easier. We want to make improvements for everyone. Let's try to figure out why this problem's happening. You go through the series of questions and you're going to dig deeper to get that answer. I lay this out in one of my trainings on developing business processes. And the example I use is, maybe one day the owner says, why do our proposals take 48 hours to turn around to our clients? And the first answer could be, we don't have a set time frame. No one ever told us that they had to be done in 48 hours. Wow, that's kind of interesting. But the other answer could be, well, we haven't been trained on the new proposal software. Mm-hmm. Another answer could be, we haven't been trained on the new automation platform we just developed. Right. So you could keep getting these answers that are all root causes, but it's in a very quick, casual, conversational approach.
Sure.
And then you can easily kind of solve the problem.
Sounds great. Well, thank you, Jason. That was terrific.
No, thanks for having me back.
Absolutely. And SmartPRENEURs, if you would like to dig in and read a little bit more, as I said, you can read the blog at SmartPRENEUR blog on our website, simplyreliable.com. And you can watch more podcasts like these with Jason and some other guests that we have on the SmartPRENEUR blog on our website, simplyreliable.com. Or you can go over to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/simplyreliable. Watch them there or at Apple Podcasts. Or you can listen to them on any place that you normally listen to your podcasts. Jason, if someone wanted some help and they wanted to reach out and find you, what would be the best way for them to get a hold of you?
They can head over to my website at imsan.com and click on the contact us link to reach out.
Well, that's awesome. Again, thanks for your time, Jason.
And thanks for having me.
And it's hard to talk over you there. And SmartPRENEURs, thanks for joining us again. Great selling out there. and check us out again on the SmartPRENEUR podcast. Have a great day.